When talking about osmotic pressures that are capable of driving water movement, we often utilize the term tonicity rather than the term osmolarity. And the rationale for this is that the term osmolarity includes all solutes. In other words, that term is essentially equivalent to or synonymous with the term concentration, meaning the amount of solute per unit volume. Tonicity, on the other hand, has another quality sort of layered on top of that, and that is that only certain solutes are capable of driving water movement across a membrane. And the only solutes capable of doing that are solutes that are impermeable across that membrane. And the rationale for that is that if a solute is permeable, it's going to move down a concentration, its own concentration gradient, until it's equal on both sides, in which case there is no gradient and it can't drive water movement. So when we refer to solutions, compare solutions and their ability to drive water movement, we really have to use the term tonicity because it includes that factor of focusing on solutes that are impermeable across a membrane, what we often refer to as effective osmoles. Now, if we were to take a cell and drop it into three different solutions, right? Note the little dots here, the solutes, and the concentration of the solutes, the density of those dots indicates the concentration of the solutions. So we take our cell and we drop it into, let's follow this one first in the middle, and we drop it into a solution that is of similar concentration outside as inside. Well, this term tonicity is comparative. In other words, in this case, we're going to say it's isotonic. The cell and the solution are isotonic. Iso referring to same tonicity, right? And so if it's the same concentration of these solutes that can't move, then we have similar chemical activities of the water on the inside and outside, right? So it's the same concentration of water, and the water fluxes in and out of the cell across aquaporins would be equal. In other words, net flux is zero. Net osmotic water flux is zero. If we were to take that same cell and now go over here on the left and drop it into a solution that is less concentrated, in other words, now the solution is hypo, less concentrated tonicity, then we have two different chemical compositions, right? Because if you look at the concentration of the solutes in the original cell here, right, they're more dense, higher concentrated than they are in this solution. And so the chemical activity of the water on the outside of the cell is greater, and we're going to get net flux of water into the cell. It's going to swell until the concentrations of the solutes and therefore the water are equal inside and outside. Now, if we go over to the far right, we do the just opposite. We take a cell and we drop it into a more concentrated solution. In this case, the solution on the outside is hyper or more concentrated, hypertonic. And of course, now the chemical activity of the water on the inside of the cell would be higher, right, driving it outward and causing the cell to shrink. Now, it's really important to note that the terms hypo and hyper and isotonic are comparative. You're comparing two things, right? And so this cell, let's go over to the left here. This cell, when you first drop it into this hypotonic solution, you could say the solution is hypotonic to the cell, to the ICF, or you could say the ICF, the cell, is hypertonic to the solution, right? So they're comparative terms. So you have to know what you're comparing to what. And again, so these are set up where we're comparing the solution on the outside to the cell at the top here.